see you, I see you.
All these girls in the club, I got my eyes on you. All these girls in the club, I got my eyes on you. All these girls in the club, I got my eyes.
Hey guys, it's Sade Jewel again, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we're coming with another story time. Well, it's not another story time, this is kind of like my first official story time. And I did like a little poll on Instagram where I told you guys to pick whichever one you wanted, as far as if you wanted a cooking video, a mini vlog, question and answer, or story time about the time. Well, we're not gonna get into that, but well, technically we are. And y'all guys chose for the story time. So today's story time, disclaimer, I did get permission from the person involved in the story to tell the story. This person actually said that they thought that I would have threw out the story as soon as it happened. They kept watching my YouTube to see if I was gonna say, you know, tell the story, but I didn't. I let time go by. But I did get permission from this person to say it. Of course, I'm gonna change everyone's name because I don't need to know who it is.
Well, duh.
Whoever knows, know. And my YouTube family, yeah, don't know who this person is, but it's okay because I'm not doing all of that. So today's story time is the time that this dude and I, we were dealing with each other, and then I found out, this is my point of view. So my point of view, now I know like the backstory, but like my point of view is, this is the time that me and his ex-girlfriend pulled up on him. Y'all.
What?
My friends, they already know the story or whatever. They like what? Okay, so what I this story is crazy. Okay, so a little backstory. Me and I'm gonna call him Leo. So me and Leo were talking, and I'm not gonna give the year, but me and Leo were talking. Well, Leo and I, we were talking. And it started getting, at least to me, it started getting serious to where like Leo would always come over. Leo would eat here. There's a time where I spent the night at Leo's house. We did like a little date or whatever the case may be. So in my mind, right, like we working towards something. All right, cool. All right. So when I first started talking to Leo, It was weird the way we started talking. Someone that I know, she had got shot. So I had posted it on my Instagram. All right, Renee. Oh, my baby's crying. Why does this always happen? All right, I'm gonna wait until he really start crying and then, okay. So yeah, this person that I know had got shot. I had posted it on my Instagram. I felt so sorry for her and stuff like that. So he commented on it and was like, oh man, like, you know, and ironically from there, that's how we started talking. So Leo also has a tight relationship with my younger daughter. Super tight relationship, always had a tight relationship with her, right? So now time is going by and I'm noticing like Leo's acting a little strange in the sense that we kept going at it for some reason. So like whatever reason it was, we just kept going at it. And it wasn't even like nothing serious, but we just kept going at it. So there were times where like we would take a day away from each other and stuff like that, where we won't talk to each other. I don't know, like it just was like really weird, all right? But I really, really, really liked Leo. Aww. Like I don't know what it was about him. Like I just genuinely did. Well, I know what it was, but yeah. I genuinely liked Leo. So I felt like Leo was posting like some weird stuff on Instagram and his stories, and I'm like, just like weird little stuff, and I'm like, hold on, me and my overthinking self, I'm like, no, he gotta be talking about somebody and he ain't talking about me.
Baby. Don't play with me, baby, because I get acting for real. But hey, I'm gonna stay out of it.
So one day he posted some lyrics from some Usher song. And it made me hit Leo up. Like, who you talking about? And of course he went at it or whatever, so he blocks me from Instagram. All right, cool, we're still talking and stuff like that. Still me, I'm still trying to like make it work or whatever the case may be. So where I told one of my homegirls, like, yo, do me a favor, go follow him and look at his stories and report back to me, you know, type timing, right? So she would look at his stories and stuff like that, and you know, like report back to me what she seen. And I'm like, all right, like, ain't nothing. So one day I get a call from the same friend, right? I get a call. So she like, yo, she said, I was looking at Leo's Instagram and her child's father caught her looking at Leo's Instagram. So he's like, why are you looking at Leo's Instagram? So she was like, oh, you know, like I'm looking at it for Sade. So he like, she was like, I'm looking at it for Sade or whatever, because he talks to Sade. So her child's father said, how does he talk to Sade if he talks to, let's say this, all right, let's say this person name is Martha. How does he talk to Sade if he talks to Martha? So she like, you know, I'm gonna tell her, right? He like, I don't care. So now my friend, my homegirl, she calls me. So she was like, you know, like I was looking at Leo page and you know, my child father said boom, 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 boom. So I'm like, you know, so I'm like, what? So she goes, I just so happened to know someone that knows Martha. So I'm like, all right, call her. Why would he hit me? I'm like, all right, call her. Oh, my camera's about to die. I gotta switch the battery. But I'm like, all right, call her. So she calls her to confirm to see if Leo and Martha are dealing with each other. The friend said, yeah, they dealing with each other. So now my homegirl, she calls me on three-way with the girl who was mutual friends with Martha. And she's like, yeah, they deal with each other, boom, boom, boom. Y'all, hold on, I gotta change my battery real quick. Oh, that's funny, Leo just texted me. That's very funny. I just told Leo, it's funny you text me while I'm doing a story time. So, oh my gosh, why is every time I want to do something, my baby starts crying? Y'all, hold on 1 second. I don't remember the last thing I said, so I will go back a little bit. So yeah, my homegirl and her friends that knew Martha, they called me together. So I'm like, yo, Leo and Martha, they deal with each other? So she like, yeah, from what I last known, they was just together the other day. So I'm like, they was together the other day? So she was like, I can get Martha on the phone if you want. Yeah, do that, please. So now I get a phone call. It's my homegirl, my homegirl's friend that knows this Martha girl, myself, and Martha on the phone. So it was so weird. So I'm like, yes, Papa. So we introduce ourselves to each other, or whatever the case it be. So she's like, you know, I'm Martha. I'm like, I'm Sade, boom, boom, boom. So, huh? So we pretty much figured out that we had the same person in common, right? So in the midst of us talking, she's telling me all this stuff that they, yes, Papa. Yo, it's so hard to like tell a story with a baby. So in the midst of that, she's telling me, yes, Papa, is the milk coming out? Watch out. Don't touch his face.
Today, we are mommy getting a caution weighted in, and it's all one son, and then
all right, watch out, Renee. All right, so now we're all on the phone, so she's telling me everything that they did and all of this stuff, and I'm just like, she's the stuff that she's telling me, I'm getting tight, right? But I'm not showing her that I'm getting tight. So she like,
you're gonna pull up and have together?
I said, I would love to. So at this time, I was dropping my kids off to school. But in the midst of, before she even said, like, do you want to pull up on him together, whatever it needs to be, the stuff that she's telling me that they did and all of this stuff, I'm texting him, like, oh, you did this, da-da-da-da, like, I'm going off. But because I know his sleep pattern, I'm like, all right, he falls asleep in the morning, so he's not going to see these messages right now. So I told her, I was like, I fucked up. I was like, I text him and stuff like that. So she was like, I hope you don't read the messages. But I'm like, because I know his sleep pattern or whatever, because we know his sleep pattern, he's not gonna see it until later. So we gotta hurry up and get over there before he wake up. So I drop my kids to school, I get back home, I text her, and at this point we exchange numbers, right? So I text her, I'm like, all right, I made it home. So she was like, all right, I'm gonna be to you in like 30 minutes, da da da. So I said, I'm gonna be done getting ready in like 30 minutes. So I put some clothes on, whatever the case to be, and I text my best friend, like, yo, boom, boom, boom. And she's like, I don't think you should go. You don't know this girl. You know, like, everybody's telling me that. But at this moment, it's like, nah, I want to bust him right now. So I remember I finished getting ready, and I text her. I said, I'm done getting dressed now, whatever the case may be. She said, give me, like, 20 minutes. I got to charge my taser. Charge your taser? She was like, I'm just letting you know, he got a hand problem. I'm like, hand problem? I'm like, okay. So I went in my little dishwasher. Yo, this story, I went in my little dishwasher, right? I pulled out a little shake, right? I put some foil on top of this so I don't stab myself, but I put it in my coat.